Most welcome to the 26th Sunday of Ordinary Time. We hear from the Gospel of Saint Mark, where we are asked to be very careful and vigilant about entering into the kingdom of God. Jesus speaks about the eternal life and how we need to be prepared. Suppose that your hand or leg or eye is causing you a sin. Jesus is exhorting us, you can remove it so that definitely you will be able to enter in the kingdom of God or heaven without those symbols which may be causing, or limbs which may be causing you a sin. What does it mean? Jesus is not asking us to eliminate our body part which may be causing the sin, but he was exhorting us to be eternally vigilant to enter into the kingdom of God. Definitely there will be stumblings, there will be sinfulness, you will be falling down. All these things are there, but you need to be prepared. You need to be lifting yourself with the help of the Lord. This is exactly what Jesus is telling. There is a soul-stirring example given in the story or the novel of Dostoevsky's Crime and Punishment. Raskolnikov, he has committed two sins. He had murdered two sisters, and he has a friend, Sonia. And often he went there, interacted with her, and she felt that he had done something wrong. And he also asks, Raskolnikov asks Sonia to read the Lazarus. And after reading it, Sonia understands that he has done something wrong, and he confesses. And he is asking her, what shall I do? He had committed the murder of two people. And this Sonia is informing him, in order to have redemption, he needed to repent. And what was she asking him? He should go to the crossroads, kneel down there, bow down, and kiss the earth and publicly repent and confess that he has committed the murder. Absolutely, he could have hide this murder, but the Sonia is telling him that he should repent, confess, and need to have the bearing of whatever he has committed. So this is exactly what Jesus is telling. You should be listening to your own conscience. You should keep your purity. Your sinfulness need to be eliminated and walk into the path of purity. Then only you will be capable of entering into the kingdom of God. So Jesus is exhorting his disciples that, and this is what he was always telling, repent in order to enter into the kingdom of God. Sinfulness is part and parcel of human life. Definitely there will be scandals. You will be falling down. You will become a stumbling block in your life. There will be crises, frustrations. But lift up your hands. Pray to the Lord. Definitely he will be there to stretch out his hands to lift you up. This is exactly what Jesus is informing us, exhorting us. In our life, we should be always vigilant against all kinds of sinfulness in our personality, cleanse ourselves, and to walk always looking towards him, walking, moving forward with him. And definitely he is with us. He is beside us and He is guiding us and He is within us, definitely then we will be prepared to enter into the kingdom of God. Wish you all a very happy Sunday.